Would you please welcome Tom Bloody Cruise?
Yeah. Yeah.
In case you missed it, Australia's quite happy to have you back,
yeah.
Tom.
I'm so happy to be here. I am so happy. It's beautiful day. It's just, I have such, you know, so many great friends here. I love it.
It's been a little while since we've seen you. Have you had much on?
A little busy, but, you know, yeah. It's been all right.
Well, I want to talk about this new film. Yeah. It's fantastic. And the Mission Impossible films, they are famous for their action, obviously, but this one's also really funny. A lot of them, they have a lot of comedy in them as well. What do you enjoy more, the action, the incredible stunts, or do you enjoy the comedy as well?
Oh, I love it. Yeah. I love it all. You know, we're constantly looking for that kind of character drama, character comedy. And Hayley Atwell really inspired this kind of action. You see the kind of talent that she is and that dynamic that we have together. And a lot of these things, we know the space that we're going to work in Rome, but we're creating those characters as we're going. So we're writing, you know, I'll be there with her and I'm watching and I'll be throwing her lines and McHugh will be working with us. So we're trying to mine that kind of character.
While you're doing like a 360 in the car?
Actually, yes. Actually, actually, yes. When we're in the 360, I was like, just keep saying the tires are on fire, we're on fire, we're on fire. We're spinning around, I know. And I was like, yeah, I'm just... And look, in Rome, they didn't know we were going to do that.
Yeah.
So they gave us that area. And then when we started, you know, I said, look, this is action. So when we were spinning, they said, you can't, you know, you only have one more take. So we kept pushing. We need another take. We need another take. So while we're spinning and doing things, and Hayley was amazing, I'll be throwing her lines. I'm going, just say we're on fire, say we're on fire. You know, I said, wait for the smoke to tire. I said, say it again, sir, because I was waiting for the smoke to come in into the scene, you know. So, yeah, we do stuff like that.
You're never allowed back to Rome, though, obviously.
Yeah.
Never allowed back to Rome.
Yeah. You know what? They did allow us back, but I thought at that moment they were going to ask us to leave.
Yeah. Sure.
They kicked out of Italy.
Is there any trepidation for you, though, Tom? Like, you could choose any kind of role. Is there any, like, thought of, oh, I'm going to just get beaten up for 3 hours doing this? You could, like, sit back and do a rom-com, you know?
Yeah, you know what? I kind of put a little rom-com in these things, yeah. too, you know? But, no, I just, look, this Mission Impossible was the very first film that I ever produced back in the 90s. So I love this franchise, and it enables me to be able to, you know, really show the world to people and take people on a great adventure. So I like all that stuff. I like producing it. I like the challenge of the physicality, the development of character and structure. It's from a storyteller's point of view, it's very interesting. An actor's point of view, it's very interesting. And, you know, you get to be able to have and create this kind of cast that we have in this film. So it's really lovely.
I think it's what makes you my favourite action hero.
Oh, thank you.
I've been on record. I'll say it again to you. What I love most about you is, yeah, people can do stunts. They can ride motorcycles and do all that sort of stuff. You have the most impressive jaw flex I have ever. No one else can do it, Tom. No one else can do it.
You're small, you know?
Huge backwards. You're watching. I've never seen it happen.
It's a jaw.
This is it. Could you? Because I...
That's
live my life to be you. But I break.
How's he doing? Is he
doing good?
I break very easily, so I don't want to do the stunt stuff. But could you teach me how to flex my jaw?
Okay.
You know, I don't. Let me just see.
Okay,
you really got. It takes a little bit. You got to loosen up. I'm not really ready for it, but.
Like that, okay, right.
Go, you've got to do it now.
He's looking at me. He's freaking.
It's
not fair. Chris is making me laugh. But you know you can't. Here we go. Close up, close up.
I mean...
You just gotta slow it down.
Yeah.
You gotta enjoy it. It's gotta be a little...
Enjoy it!
You know.
Oh, that's good. That's good. Do you, in those moments, though, do you have something that you say to yourself, Tom, to be like, OK, this is the part that the fans are going to love, Robe's going to love this, let's get in the zone.
I'm doing this one for Robe!
Yeah.
I had no idea. I really had no idea. None.
You brought back Maverick, you brought back Ethan Hunt. Are we going to see maybe a revival of what could be happening with the kid from Risky Business, do you think?
Oh, yeah.
That's very interesting.
Asking for a friend.
Can you imagine that? Could you imagine? You know what, when years after they wanted to do it and I wasn't ready to do it, I don't know. I don't know what that story would be, actually. I don't know. Do you have any Want to pitch me an idea?
Oh, gosh, do we have time? Yes. He's gone he's into still... corporate law and yeah. also on the side solves crime.
Really?
Yeah.
A private eye, detective of sorts.
Still dances in
still
his
dancing.
Still dancing?
Totally. Yeah. That's how he unwinds.
That's good. Alone.
Alone. Yes. Alone. But you know, we can get a rom-com, build it in.
A lot of time in the writer's room.
This is your jaw flex, I think.
Sorry, yeah, it could be. It really could be.
Tom, a lot of people have credited you in bringing back Top Gun Maverick, getting people back into cinemas. Getting really excited about going in, seeing it on the big screen, and I know that was important to you, but it seems like since then, there's actually a whole bunch of them. And more people excited about obviously going to see this film as nice. Well, but in the cinemas.
Yeah.
Why is that so important for you?
It's a beautiful art form. I make my movies for cinemas, and I know it's like they come out in the other platforms, that's fine, but to have that experience, I love that experience. I love seeing movies with an audience, and it's a... It is a different art form, and there's just something about that community and what we can deliver for an audience on a big screen with the sound. I mean, I didn't want them cutting the screens up smaller into cineplexes. I remember in the 80s, that's why I started shooting, you know, I started pushing large formats of 65 millimeter and big screen experience, and I've always been really studying what we're doing with sound and visually to immerse an audience in a story. So I personally love it. It is a different mindset in making a film like that. Mm. And what's better than all of us together in a theater together experience? We can all have different problems, walks of life, everything. We're all experiencing something together. It is a cultural, beautiful thing. And I know that everyone, you know, we're talking about what we've all been through collectively as humanity. I think more. Like, I don't like Zoom meetings. don't like emails. I don't want Zoom meetings. It's like, I tell my crew, it's like, guys, you got to come talk to me. We're all going to
have Zoom meetings in a big cinema.
I know. production meetings, okay? I want to see your face. I want to talk to you. That's the fun of making movies, you know, to all be together and do it. It's a very tactile, physical art form, and that's what I like.
Well, you love the audience. The audience loves you. Do not go anywhere.
I make my movies for audiences. I've always no matter what genre, you know. And I've always wanted to make movies. I go and I make it, and I'm studying film all the time. So I love it.
Be honest. Was it actually you?
Yeah, was it you?
Pardon me?
Was it you? Was it actually you?
Can you believe you actually? You have to ask that.
Come on, we got it. You know. Yeah. You can
yes,
tell me.
Yes, I can tell you honestly, that was me. every rev, every foot, every second. It's a lot of fun.
And is it true that this is one you had wanted to do since you were a kid?
I used to build ramps, and I used to figure out how I could jump bikes and stuff and motorcycles. Yeah, I wanted to do that. But, of course, McHugh designed it in this epic style. So we had to figure out, we picked that location because the bowl is visual, and then I had to build the ramp. And then I mean, that morning, there was ice on the ramp, so we had to clean the ice off. Yeah, that helicopter, you have to worry about that helicopter coming across and blowing me off the ramp. Because I know. I thought, we got to get this right. So we did a lot of prep for this.
Now, I should remind you, you're Tom Cruise. You know that. Yeah. You don't need to be doing this.
Yeah.
That's a good thing. I say we're going to do it, and they let me do it.
Oh, you talk about the prep, Tom. What went into this, right? Because it seems like there's one thing to plan it, but then you've got ice, then you've got a helicopter, then you've got all this other stuff. Then you have to be you to be able to do it. Like, how?
We just kind of said we're going to do it, and then we backed up from there. Where do we shoot it? How do we shoot it? And that kind of training I did. Lots of skydiving, tracking, working again on the motorcycle, lots of motorcycle jumps. And then I practiced a lot of unusual attitudes when I was skydiving so that I would jump very low. I'd start high, do unusual attitudes and see how fast I can recover. So then we brought the helicopter down. So I was at lower altitudes with no altimeter so that I know. So I was basically counting out seconds in my head as I was going. Because if anything happened when I was cutting across, we actually built a ramp in England because I had to test to see what's it going to be like, what's the bike, how's it going to behave. We tested wind direction and drones because we also had to figure out how are we going to shoot this. what piece of equipment do we use? And at the last second, we decided to use a helicopter when we were in Norway. And I didn't train with the helicopter. We had a great helicopter pilot. And he was watching me train so that he saw my rhythm. So there's things that I didn't, you know, I didn't have a speedometer. I had to have the feel so that I'm consistent, that everything that I do is very consistent. Mm. And then when I leave the bike, we didn't know what was going to happen on the mountain for the real thing. So I would, right before I did the jump off the ramp, I would go in over a helicopter, low altitude, and jump off the skid so that I could get in the bowl to feel what that wind is going to be like. So I would jump into the bowl, and then I would open my parachute in the bowl. So I was used to, you know, because also once the parachute opens, you have to watch that you're not going to get turned into the side of the mountain.
Yeah.
Because it sounds so complicated, and there's a thing called CGI nowadays. But I feel like before you were talking about, like, wanting people to come and see the movies in cinema, and so are you putting yourself through these physical risks as a kind of, like, a tentpole to be like, hey, come and see me. This is why you're paying to come to movies.
I want to give everything. And this is, you cannot, I don't care, and I, you... To have that experience, to see that, for it to, it communicates to an audience when it's real. It's different. There's stakes. There's real stakes. And it's also all technically all the things that I'm handling, and there's performance. So part of that is they can put cameras in places with me that you might not think of when you're doing CG. Or it just has a different emotional vibe. As talented as those guys are, it has a different emotion for the audience. It has a different quality. And I grew up watching practical action and thinking about ways that how can I, you know, like, we use old technology and we're creating new technology with these, whether Top Gun, Maverick. I spent a long time, as I'm a pilot, I fly aerobatics, I fly jets, I fly propeller airplanes and parachutes. And I spent years evaluating aerial photography and developing aerial photography that we used in American Made, a movie that I did, and then Fallout with the helicopters. All of that was prep for Top Gun Maverick. And each film that we've gone from Top Gun Maverick to Dead Reckoning Part 1 and Dead Reckoning Part 2. So you'll see all that kind of technology applied, and the way that I train the actors to prepare them for these movies. Mm. Not just for stunts, but to be able to act and perform within that. Because watching a stunt is, you know, you can see that on anywhere, you know, YouTube or whatever. But this is... want to immerse you in a story, you talk about character, you talk about story structure. So how do we, where do we put the camera? How do we involve them in that?
I'm still on training wheels. This is incredible. This is incredible.
Tom, there's a lot of moments in this film where I think to myself, has Tom ever heard of a helmet?
I know.
I feel like you've heard this a bit?
Yeah,
it just doesn't look cool.
There you go.
I wear helmets, you know, when I ride motorcycles and I'm training and I wear pads, but when you start to go film, all the pads come off. Mm. So I train in jumping and, you know, race bikes and high-speed bikes, but then it's not cinematic.
There's parents of 8-year-old boys all over Australia right now saying, don't listen to Tom.
I know, don't. Here's the thing, when you're making your movie, that, you know, that's... but. I train with helmets. We all wear pads. You know, I wear that stuff. But when I do it, I have to take it all off.
How do you reassure everybody not to just panic?
Yeah.
Like you make me feel
he's
very
got
calm.
Got a great
right
insurance
now.
Broker. Yeah.
Okay, there you go.
That's a very good question, because we just have a rule. I treat every. It's like just calm, easy. It's another day, you know. You don't want people looking at you like, you know, before you go.
Get out of your car. Oh, no!
Coming up to you going,
okay. What's he doing?
You don't want that. I don't want that. I want everyone to be, you know, and I'm very relaxed.
Just chill.
And everyone, and just so we go through it and we rehearse these days so everyone is just really calm.
Oh, but can people actually be that way with you, Tom? If we're going back to Mission Impossible, one of my favourite bits of tech in that movie is, of course, the masks, right? And the reveal. Fine. If you could have a mask of just an average person, no one knows who you are, and you could walk about your life, no one knows that you're Tom Cruise, what are you doing?
Beg your pardon?
What are you doing? Like, it's not you.
What would I do?
Yeah, what would you do? No one knows it's you. They can't be there.
No, but I just do the same thing I always do.
Go watch movies.
Go watch movies. Exactly. Go make movies, go tour the world. You know, I feel very... Look, it's a privilege. It's a dream of mine my whole life to do what I do and travel the world, the places where I was in America, and just work in these environments. And the kind of welcome that I get, I never take it for granted. It's very beautiful. So I enjoy it. I enjoy people, you know, and people are so kind to me, and I really cherish those moments. I really do. And it's something that I like having a chat, you know what I mean? I like sitting down hearing about people's lives, and it's also a privilege because when I'm here, people will share that with me, and it's very nice. We have a commonality of movies and culture going. I'm sorry.
Tomorrow, Georgie and I are going to see you at the premiere. Yeah, we're very much looking forward to it. Yeah. Also, your birthday.
Yes, it is. Yeah. Yeah. 61.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you
very much. Yeah. I know. I know, they were like, where do you want to... And it's like, Sydney, I'm going to go have my birthday and premiere in Sydney. Yeah. Okay. So I chose that date to be here. I thought it would be fun. I'm either working... I'm on a sound stage, mixing stage, making movies or promoting movies for my whole life.
Okay.
That's how I've spent my birthdays, most of them.
We'll, we'll shoot a birthday cake out of a helicopter.
That'd be good. Exploding.
Threw it on a bar.
Well, Mission Impossible Dead Reckoning Part 1 is in cinemas this Saturday, July 8th. Please put your hands together for Tom.
Thank you.